Hi, I'm AJ Hart, and as an author, I have a ton of books to read. In fact, let's take a moment of our time and read a book right now. And the book that I want to read is Time Warp Trio. Summer reading is killing me. Let's go read it right now. Now, before we get into that, this video is brought to you by Tubi. Now, everyone knows Netflix and everyone knows Hulu, but you have to pay monthly for that stuff. So why do that when you can go to Tubi, where you can watch old TV shows like Flintstones, Silver Spoons, Braceface, for completely no price at all. So take a moment of your time and check out Tubi. That's T-U-B-I, Tubi. Alright, let's get into the book.
Listening Library presents The Time Warp Trio Number 7, Summer Reading is Killing Me, by Jon Scieszka. Read for you by Joshua Swanson.
Chapter 1. Cluck, cluck. The thing rumbled in a deep voice. "Is that thing talking to us?" said Fred. I looked around the small playground. Fred, Sam, and I stood at one end against a chain-link fence. A very large, white, feathered thing stood next to the swing set at the other end. It had yellow, scaly legs as big as baseball bats, little red eyes, and a dog collar. "I think it's a giant chicken," I said. Sam cleaned his glasses on his t-shirt and took another look at the other side of the playground. "Yes, that is a 250-pound chicken standing there." The sun glittered in its hungry little eyes. "And yes, he looks like he's planning to hurt us," added Sam.
"Hey, it's not my fault," said Fred. "I didn't touch the book."
"You did too," I said.
"Did not," said Fred.
"Did too.
Did not. Did too."
"Excuse me, guys," said Sam. "Did you ever get the feeling that all of this has happened before? Exactly like this?"
The super-sized chicken eyed us. He gave another gut-rumbling cluck.
"Well, except with maybe a black knight instead of a giant chicken, of course." Fred pushed back his Red Wings hat and scratched his head.
"Hey, yeah, it's like a la mode or something."
The chicken pecked the ground hungrily with jackhammer blows of its beak.
"You mean deja vu," said Sam, backing up against the fence. "And Joe, isn't this right about when you should do some magic trick and get us out of here?"
I stood there, stunned, looking at a giant white chicken on a city playground. The swing set, the slide, the gravel, even the impossible chicken. Sam was right. Everything did look familiar, but not really familiar. I couldn't put my finger on it.
Joe?
Joe?
Said Sam, elbowing me in the ribs while keeping his eye on the hungry chicken. "The magic trick?"
"It's like I've been here before, but I haven't really been here before," I said.
The monster bird twisted its head. It looked us over with one eye, then the other.
"Well, thank you for sharing your feelings," said Sam. "And you know, we would just love to hear more later. Right now, it looks like that bird is thinking about his own idea of chicken dinner. Us. So how about that magic trick?"
The killer fowl started bobbing and walking toward us. Fred bounced his fist off the top of my head.
"Yeah, come on, Joe. You are the worst magician I've ever known. Your book got us into this. Do a real magic trick for once and get us out of here."
The chicken started trotting. I racked my brain. There was no way I was going to try the classic abracadabra or hocus pocus, magic words to stop a charging chicken. And don't even remind me of that please and thank you mistake I made earlier in my career. But I had a flash of an idea. I thought it could work. It just might work. So I gave it a try. Why did the chicken cross the road? I yelled. The chicken only flapped its wings and ran faster. I cupped my hands like a megaphone and yelled punchlines. To get to the other side! To buy the newspaper! To get away from Colonel Sanders! Nothing worked. The monster chicken just looked madder and ran at us faster. I don't want to end up as chicken feed, wailed Sam, plastered against the fence. At that moment, I saw a sign out of the corner of my eye, and I knew where we were. The chicken thundered toward us, its deadly sharp beak pointed directly at us. I stepped in front of Sam and Fred with my chest out. Hoboken, I said. Chicken, said Fred. Emergency, screamed Sam. Exactly. Chapter 2. This is going to be impossible to explain, but give me a chance and just let me try. I think I know what happened. To get back to the very beginning, my life has not been the same since my Uncle Joe gave me the book for my birthday. This book is a small book, a dark blue book with strange silver writing on it, a book like no book I've ever read before or since. It's a time-warping book. I know, I can hear you laughing right now. You're saying to yourself, what's with this guy? He probably still believes in the Easter Bunny and the Tooth Fairy. Everybody knows you can't travel through time with a book. I don't blame you for not believing. I didn't really believe it myself either. Then we opened the book and started going places. Since then, my friends, Sam and Fred and I, have gotten into trouble in just about every time from the Stone Age to the future. We've run into pirates, robots, cavemen, you name it. We've been chased by a woolly mammoth, stampeded by cattle, turned into mummies, and nearly suffocated by one very nasty-smelling giant. And we still have absolutely no idea how to work the book. The only thing that seems to stay the same is the green...
We're gonna stop there. Now, I know we didn't get much of the story done, but if you really want more, check out Time Warp Trio. Summer reading is killing me. Have a good one.